Kenondo!
Welcome, welcome, welcome back to Kenondo. I am Kenondo and I'm rushing my intro today because I'm talking about Endgame! Guys, Endgame is the best movie of 2019. I don't even care. This movie is incredible. I've seen it 3 times already, and I'm going to see it even more because this movie needs to be the highest grossing movie of all time. Hashtag watch Endgame, hashtag beat Avatar. On that third viewing, I noticed something that kind of interested me, and I'm legitimately surprised that nobody's mentioned it yet. Is that because nobody cares, it's not a thing, or because I'm the smartest person on the planet? But probably not that last one. Before I move on, there is a massive spoiler warning for Avengers Endgame. If you haven't seen it, go and see it! Hashtag watch Endgame, hashtag beat Avatar! Okay, so here's my hypothesis. The original Avengers each represent one of the stages of grief. Grief is a powerful emotion that almost all of us will feel at some point in our lives. It completely derails you, and it's really hard to get back on track afterwards, at least without help. Most people know that grief comes in stages, but psychologists have varying opinions on how many stages there are to grief. The most common model is that of 5 stages, these being denial, anger, bargaining, depression, and acceptance. This model, coined by Elizabeth Kubler-Ross, is the most widely known model, but recently people have been considering a 6th step that comes before them all. Shock. When I first came up with this, I looked only at the original 5, but after reading into it, I realized that all 6 line up pretty nicely with the original 6 Avengers. And here's how. The first stage, shock, is relatively simple. When a tragedy occurs, you feel numb. Shock is the reaction that forms out of a feeling of disbelief, leaving a feeling of being temporarily numb. This is the most tenuous link, but I think that shock is best represented by Natasha. Nat has never really been the type to wear her emotions on her sleeve, but in the beginning of Endgame, she seems particularly nonplussed about this all. She doesn't really have a reaction to the snapping. Now, this could be that she's had 20 days to recuperate, but this isn't really likely since, you know, half of all life was snapped out of existence by Cyanosis Homer Simpson. When she explains to Tony that Thanos did exactly what he said he'd do, he wiped out half of all life, there does seem to be a tone of disbelief in her voice, like she can't fathom that they've actually failed. And as I mentioned earlier, disbelief is a symptom of the shock stage. Now we've established the first stage, let's move on, as most grievers do, to denial. Denial comes in different forms. Usually, it's the victim denying that the tragedy actually happened, but it can also be them denying that they were affected by the events. Sound familiar? In Thor's first scene after the time skip, he's adamant that he's fine, and that he's not scared of Thanos, because, in his words, "Why would I be afraid of that guy? I killed that guy, remember?" Thor's whole arc is him coming to terms with his failure, dealing with the fact that he can't deny any longer. He lost. He failed. Honestly, Thor's entire arc is beautiful, heartbreaking, and from experience, realistic. A quick side note before we move on, I really respect Marvel's restraint in only making 2 fat jokes the entire movie, and having Thor remain schlubby and still kick major ass in the climax. Plus-size superheroes are rare, because of the nature of the job, but I respect them introducing one in a natural and believable way. Anger is quite obvious, and is honestly the stage that got me thinking about this. Anger is represented by Tony. When he returns to Earth, he gets mad. He's snapping and yelling and breaking down. He's angry. Angry that he was proven right, that his worst fears of remaining alive while those around him died came true. And he takes it out on everyone in the room, but especially Steve. It's a really powerful scene, but it's not the one that swayed me. That comes much later, when Tony makes my job much easier and spells out exactly what I'm saying. Turns out resentment is toxic, and I hate it. That pretty much sums up exactly what I'm trying to say. His emotion in this movie is anger, and he hates it, which just creates more anger. After anger, for most people, comes bargaining. and this one is only for a little while, but bargaining is represented by Steve. When he walks in on Nat crying, he tells her that he saw a pod of whales on the way over, in the Hudson. There's fewer ships, cleaner water. He's bargaining with himself. He's looking on the bright side, trying to say that maybe this was a good thing, maybe Thanos' plan worked out for the best. But he can't do it. He can't move on. And so, we move on to the hardest stage to get out of. Depression. Depression is, well, I can't describe it and do it the justice it deserves, so I'll let Ms. Kubler-Ross do it. The victim finally realizes that he has no control in preventing the outcome, and he may turn away from loved ones, believing that there is no one who can understand what he's going through, or no one who can help him feel better. You all hopefully know where I'm going with this. When Nat tracks down Clint to re-recruit him, he says to her, "No, don't give me hope." If those five words don't sum up the depression stage absolutely perfectly, then I am Iron Man. Clint is a broken shell of his former self in the start of Endgame. He's lost all hope, like he's lost his family. He takes his pain out on others, killing those who he believes should have been vanished. And once he gets recruited, he's more than ready to risk his life testing the time machine in Scott's place. He just doesn't care anymore. He's well and truly depressed. And I don't think he ever moves past it, at least not in this movie. He never reaches acceptance, which is of course represented by Professor Hulk. Come on, everything this guy says is based around acceptance. Banner fused himself with Hulk after thinking of Hulk as the cure rather than the disease. He accepts his role in the team when he volunteers to put on the gauntlet. "It's like I was born for this." He accepts that Nat isn't coming back. He accepts that he could die from using the gauntlet. This guy accepts so damn much! So there you go. The six Avengers all represent a stage of grief. Do you agree with my theory? Do you disagree? Do you think I'm talking out of my ass? Let me know in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video, please consider leaving a like and subscribe to see more Kinundo content. I do all sorts of stuff, from skits to mini video essays like this to reviews to gaming, so stick around if any of that tickles your fancy. Regardless, thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!